This is the story of a blind date couple, Anna from Wembley and Paul from Portsmouth. Now, we were there when they met, we were there when they got engaged, and now we've all been invited to a very special blind date wedding. And where are they getting married? Well, where better than right here on the fabulous island of Barbados. Barbados. We're here to see Anna and Paul tie the knot in their totally tropical blind date wedding. And we'll also be catching up with all their preparations for the big day. We'll be joining Paul as he gets to grips with all the ups and downs of a stag night. We'll be keeping up with Anna as she enjoys a racy time at a hen party. And I'll be revealing the true identity of wedding hat number 3. But before I put on that hat, let's remind ourselves of how it all began. Blind date 1993, as Anna prepares to ask her questions, little does she know that one of these three boys has the answers that will change her life forever.
My ambition is to be a gladiator. If I was, I'd be called Spark, because I'm a bit of a live wire and have an electrifying personality. If you were a gladiator, what would you be called and why?
I think it would have to be a tiger, because I'm strong, powerful, and when I go in for the kill, nothing can stop me.
Eeny, meeny, miny, mo, who are you going to go for?
Number 2.
Here he is. Did you hear number 2? That was Paul from Portsmouth. Big Paul. There you go. Well, let's see where you're going on your blind date.
Would you like to choose?
No, I'll leave it to you.
I'll insist.
Okay, ooh. I'll take it.
Yes, get down there. Choose, choose. Right. Choose. I hope it's a good one. What are you going to do to him? I mean, you're very forceful, Anna.
I am indeed.
Oh, my God. A date in Switzerland.
Oh, yes. Love it.
Okay, come on, it's so easy.
Cheers, Scylla.
Thank you, Scylla.
And after their fabulous date, this is what they had to say about each other.
First time I saw Anna, it was, obviously I was impressed, but it's quite difficult with everything else going on around. To be honest, I really just sort of remember seeing this smiley face, and I just went up and gave her a hug and a kiss.
If I brought Paul to Luton, and if my friends saw him, they would go weak at the knees, because they probably would find him sexy.
If Anna was to make, advances towards me, I'd be very happy, yeah, definitely.
Paul's smile is a winning smile, in the sense that you could be easily charmed by it if you are not wary of him, if you're not too sure of him, if you don't know Paul very well, then he could win you over with a smile like that. He could, very easily.
If Anna and myself, keep in contact and keep seeing each other, then, you know, who knows what the future may hold.
You actually said you fancied, or your girlfriends fancied him.
That's right.
If you took him back to Luton, yes, all your girlfriends would go, oh, lovely. Does that mean that you secretly fancy him as well?
Oh, that would be telling, wouldn't it? Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. And she's very secret.
But you totally look very at ease with each other.
It was amazing, because usually I'm bossy. Mm-hmm. But
you weren't on the date, were you?
I was very bossy on the date, but it was all right because he was very easygoing.
Yeah, like so
we gelled.
Good combination.
Together. You gelled together. Oh, nice. Now, the burning question, you've got to be seeing each other again, because, you know, I've only wore the app once. I mean, are you going to see each other again?
Yeah.
Well, that kiss was just the beginning. And when they returned for the blind date exclusive, Paul had a big surprise for us all.
Okay, I mean, do it on TV. Anna, will you marry me?
And so the wedding was on. But first things first. The date had been set, the location had been found, but before Anna and Paul could jet off to the Caribbean, they both had some serious shopping to do. Shopping, Anna and her bridesmaid Jo decided it was time to talk to the experts about what to wear on the big day.
Okay, Anna, so I believe you're getting married in Barbados, is that right?
Yes.
Okay, do you have any idea about the sort of dress you want?
Olivia, I haven't a clue about the sort of dress I want to wear. You've got to help me.
Okay, you have come to just the right place.
Olivia, I feel fantastic.
Great.
What do you think? Smile. Oh, please yourself.
Meanwhile, Paul and his best man, Seamus, were also working out their wedding day look.
Sharp?
Cool.
I think we should pose.
Let's pose. Excellent stuff. What do you reckon?
Just about, yeah, just about ready for Barbados.
I think so.
Apart from one thing.
What's that?
Well, as we're going to Barbados...
Shades.
Yeah. All right. I think now we're ready for Barbados.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Cool.
I
really do. Well, with the shopping out the way, it was time to party. So we asked the bridesmaid and the best man, Joanna and Seamus, to each take a camcorder so the lads and the girls could record a fly on the wall account of the hen night and the stag weekend.
Let's do it. Let's do it. We're bunching. Let's go! Let's go!
So where's Scylla at a point like this? That's what I want to know.
Anna, I love you. Five, three. Four, three, two, one, go!
Bungee jumping, the lads needed a drink and some arresting entertainment.
There is Paul. Congratulations. You better grab what you can because it might be your last.
You worked on that one.
eye-popping experience at dinner, the lads hit the streets.
I think we just need to go to a pub because I need a real drink right now, so...
There's too many blanks, so I'll have to put my dress on.
Eventually, the time had come for Anna to sign off as the girls' night drew to a close.
Had a good time here tonight, so we're going to call it a night and leave the rest to your imagination.
But for the lads, the night had just begun.
Fortunately, tonight, this club is like full of beautiful girls, but unfortunately, you can't have any. They're all mine.
I know that.
That's right. All mine and all your friends.
No competition.
Paul to board the plane for Barbados.
Welcome to Colony Club. We're going to make sure you have a fantastic wedding, a very special day. Do come through.
Well, having arrived safely in Barbados, Anna, Paul and the gang had a couple of days to settle into the Caribbean way of life. And what did they do? Well, they hit the beach, of course. Someone loves you, honey. Begin, it's time for a quick break. We'll be back in a mo when we'll be joining Anna and Paul for all the excitement of the big day itself. But before we go, here's a message from a couple who know exactly what a blind date wedding is all about.
Paul and Anna, congratulations. Have a really lovely day.
But be warned, after a blind date wedding, two can become four. Congratulations. Have a wonderful day.
Congratulations, Paul and Anna. Have a wonderful day.
I hope when you're as young and sprightly as we are, that you'll be as happy as we are and as much in love. Enjoy your day. Have a wonderful time.
To you.
Well, here it is, the third blind date wedding hat. What do you think? What? Oh, well, please yourselves. I did me best. Anyway, I've just heard that Anna and Paul are on their way. So let's all take our seats for the blind date wedding.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right,
chap.
Hey,
how are you doing, man?
Obviously a little nervous, not having been married before, but I'm looking forward to it.
Can I help you out there, Anna? Be careful, there's a little step there, okay? Make it.
I might leave my lid behind.
Got it. Looking absolutely gorgeous.
Thank
absolutely
you.
Fantastic.
Thank you very much.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to this marriage ceremony for Paul and Anna.
I call on these persons here present.
To witness that I.
To witness that I.
Paul Christopher Pratt.
Paul Christopher Pratt.
Do take you.
Do take you.
Anna Maria Shidu Akron Azawana.
Anna Maria Azawana.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To be my lawful wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
To death us do part.
According to God's holy law.
According to God's holy law.
And to this I pledge myself.
And to this I pledge myself.
All four hands on the book. Today we've witnessed Paul and Anna as they have made their covenant to God. In our presence they've made their vows one to the other. Today they've shown their consent by joining hands, by giving and receiving rings. I therefore pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord bless you and keep you. Amen.
Watching there in the front,
yeah.
Little tear in your eye.
Absolutely, it's been ever so emotional, but it's been absolutely beautiful, wonderful, hasn't it?
Well, it is your little boy. How did you feel out there being a mum, you know, your little boy?
Relieved. Not nastily, but relieved because Anna loves him and he loves Anna, and she's going to look after him and he's going to look after her. And it's just nice because, you know, the next generation is cemented. So I do feel actually relieved, but nicely.
Well, you look far too young. Are you hoping for grandchildren on the horizon?
Oh, yes, I don't want to be a granny.
Oh.
And I'm very pleased I've got a daughter as
well,
because she's beautiful.
Well, now, Josie, you're Anna's mum. And also, you gave Anna away. How did you feel about that?
Oh, lovely. On top of the wall.
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, you look absolutely stunning.
Thank you.
What about when Anna told you that she was first coming on Blind Date? How did you feel
I
about that?
I couldn't believe it. I said, you're joking. I said, come home and tell me about it. Not on the phone.
Not on the phone?
No, I won't take it.
And when you met Paul, what did you think?
Oh, I opened my door. I said, hey. Look what we got here. I looked at him. Lovely boy.
He is a gorgeous
boy. Ah, make up my family.
I've got to say a little word about Anna. Anna, basically, darling, you've never failed to surprise me. And today has been one of those days, just because you got here on time, no. Today has been one of those days. You look stunning. The dress looks amazing, and I can't wait to get it off later. Yeah.
See ya.
Good night, and God bless. Say good night, don't forget and throw your bouquet. Wonderful way. afraid that's all we've got time for on this very special edition of Blind Date. And on behalf of everybody here in Barbados, we wish you ta-ra. Ta-ra, everyone!
I saw you dancing up the ocean, running fast along the sand, the spirit born of earth and water, fire flying from your hands. In the instant that you love someone.
Next Sunday at 5 to 7, Emma Ray returns as Donna in My Wonderful Life. Meanwhile, stay with us tonight for a wedding anniversary in Coronation Street.
Reality runs up your spine.